Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, we're going to ponder the question, can I use conditional formatting with field parameters? It depends. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. We got this question on one of our live streams from Matthias, who's there every morning. That's usually the first question that we go through in our Saturday Q&As. If you're not familiar with it, we do live streams every Saturday at 9:30 a.m. Central Time. So go check those out if you want to take part in the community and ask questions and learn a bunch of great things. But Matthias's question was interesting in the fact that he wanted to use field parameters, but he wanted to use conditional formatting as well, and he was struggling with getting that to work. And this was a little bit of a journey. I started immediately. I was just like, field parameters don't support. Hang on a second. You know how we like to do it here on Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. Let's start with the basics, right? So if we're talking about conditional formatting, if I have a visual, we've got a matrix here. I've got a measure that's in the values well. If I select here, I can do conditional formatting and I can set up what I need to do to get colors to show up. Cool. If we go to field parameters, this gives us the ability to switch between different categories and then we can have different values, which is amazing and awesome. But if we actually go here to the values, we don't have conditional formatting. That's because this actual item is not a measure. It is a calculated column. What do we do? That was the question. You know, Patrick, he goes down, he's like, all right, we're gonna write some DAX. And I'm sitting there going like, there's gotta be an easier way. So let's see what we did. Let's start with Patrick's. Patrick went immediately to DAX because that's what he loves. And we can see here we do have color variation, right? So we've got this yellowish color and then we've got this bluish color on other values. When you're doing things like this, just be aware of accessibility and color blindness. This may be indistinguishable for some people. So sometimes adding icons and things like that are also helpful. For those that maybe can't see it, trust me, these values here are yellowish and then these values here are bluish. So we do have different color variations going on here because conditional formatting has kicked in. And if I change to total quantity, we can see the same thing. Different values, different color variations. So what he did was, first off, he said, well, let me write a measure that will give me the color variation. So he wrote this SM for selected measure. And what he's doing there is using a switch statement. We use is selected measure, and then we do this color or we do that color. He's using DAX to get these color switching. And then there is a color result that gets turned back based on the value. So now how do we actually get the colors to show up? So if you select your visual, go over to the format this visual. It took us a second to figure out where this was, but I had the idea. I'm like, Patrick, we don't need this on the field or the measure directly in the field. Well, there's actually properties in the visual itself where you can define conditional formatting as part of it. So let's go do that. Let me show you where it is. One thing we did was search for conditional, and all of a sudden we see these items that come up under cell elements and they are there. They don't say conditional format, but those are the conditional formatting items. So if I get rid of this and we just look, you'll see cell elements down here and you can see that these items are available, right? So we can have icons, we can have backgrounds, but we turned on font color and we're setting up the actual conditional formatting as part of the cell value itself. And we're basically assigning it to the measure that Patrick defined. And that's how this magic is working. So this was Patrick's idea. He went full board DAX and I'm like, no. There's gotta be an easier way. Like, let's just use the clicks. You don't need to use all this DAX. So if we come over to mine, we can see that there's actually a gradient here. So these are kind of yellowish. They go into a darker yellow and then come down to a blue and then finally to this purple color. And if I switch to freight, we can see the same. It's kind of this yellowish. We get some blues down here and then we get this purple down at 25,000. So how did I do this? Same location, make sure your visual is selected. We're gonna go over to the cell value. And then instead of doing an actual measure, I'm just saying, look, gradient based on the measure itself, and then choose my lowest, middle, highest. You can just do the two values if you want. Here's the trick, and this is the same for the way that Patrick did it, is you have to configure this for each selection. If I define it for total freight, I've got to then come back, select total quantity, and do the whole thing again. Let's go back to Patrick so I can illustrate this a little bit more. Total freight, I'm going to turn it off. So we'll go to cell elements, I'm going to turn it off. So we think that we turned off conditional formatting. Well, if I go to total quantity, functionality, it's still enabled. So when you're configuring this, make sure you actually go through each selection and then you have to configure each selection. And if you're setting up the gradient, the values that I did, you've got to go through and pick all those colors for each selection. So if you've got more than that, if you've got six items, you got to go through this six times. And that's regardless of whether you're doing Patrick's approach or my approach. And so each selection's configuration is independent of the other. All right, that's bananas. Which item would you go through? Patrick's crazy DAX way or my simple learn the clicks way? Let me know in the comments below. We want to hear it. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.